I'm trying to show my people who've lost their jobs how they can make money online so that they can invest, right? So that's the goal.
Cool.
All right. Awesome. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
The free mama today on the Invest Diva movement. She is the queen of making money doing freelancing. And it's just mind blowing because she's just made so much money doing that. And she teaches people how to do it. And it's funny because before we get into how you do it, I just wanted to give you a little backstory, because when I was on the show and you gave the backstory, I'm like, oh my God, that's true. We met at a charging station to charge our phone, basically. And that's how we met on Final Hiking Live last year. And it's been really cool. And I'm super glad that you've been able to make it today. I know your kids are home and they're crying and, you know, you're quarantining. So super happy and appreciative that you were able to make it. And Lauren, walk us through this magic of making money through doing freelancing. Can anybody do it?
Anybody can do it. And that's what I love so much about it. So like my own story was, I became a mom before I got into business. And I know some, you know, everybody's kind of got their own journey, but I was pretty like the way our society wants us to be. I hate to say that, but that's what, I went to school, I got good grades. Then you go to college, then you get a job, then you get married. Like I just was super vanilla, like doing all the things that we should do. Yeah. The problem was I found myself 23 years old, married, at a job, and not super happy or fulfilled. I love my husband. That wasn't the issue. I liked the work I did, so I didn't know if that was the issue. And it really wasn't until I became a mom that I was like, oh, I think it's not the work, it's the working for someone else. When they tell me I have to work, how they tell me I have to work, who they tell me I have to work with. And I realized, I'm driven, I'm smart, I'm capable. And I just wanted to take my lifestyle, the time that I invested every day and what I was doing and who I got to do it with. I wanted more control. Basically, I'm a control freak. And so I tried a lot of different things. I always joke, if you've ever Googled how to make money from home, I've tried it. And it wasn't until I landed on freelancing that I was like, wow, this, more people, especially more moms, should realize how accessible this is to them. And I always say, if you have a computer, an internet connection, you have everything you need to get started as a freelancer. And I don't know that there's any other career, including online, where the barrier of entry is so low. You don't have to have a degree. You don't have to have gone to college. You don't have to have certifications. You just need a computer and Wi-Fi. And then everything else is just filling in the blanks, which I'm sure we'll dive into a lot more details on how to do that during this interview.
Right. So let me clear something up, because is this different than being an entrepreneur? Like, do you have to become a business owner? Because like, I'm an entrepreneur and I also do some kind of freelancing on this. I don't know what actually falls into the freelancing category.
I got you. I know where you're going. So I think a little bit of this does have different definitions, but I also think some of it is semantics. And like, if someone was working as a freelancer and they called themselves an entrepreneur, I'm not going to be offended. Like, just whatever makes you feel good. But yes, being a freelancer is kind of like being an employee, or kind of like having a job, but you're not an employee. So often as a freelancer, you're what's considered a W-9er. W-9er, so you fill out a W-9, not a W-2. You're issued a 1099 as a freelancer, or a small business owner. You could be a sole proprietor, or you could open an LLC. So there are different legal entities. There's different tax structures. So I do like to think of myself as a freelancer, as a small business owner, because I don't have a boss. I don't necessarily have employees either. So I might not be building, a corporation or something, but you are your own, you're your own entity. And what kind of legal entity and tax entity you take on is up to you as an independent contractor.
Right. So you teach people how to become a freelancer. And like, is this something that actually, and I know it might be a little bit kind of like, I'm not trying to offend you, but like people are like, okay, I'll just go become a freelancer. Like, what are some of the pitfalls that you fell into? They were like, oh my God, I have to educate people so that they don't make the same mistakes. Cause I know that you have like a massive following of people who worship you. And I'm like, oh, so freelance, why didn't they do it on their own? Why did they need the guidance? So what are the things that I need guidance.
Yeah, the biggest holdups. I think some of the biggest holdups are, again, kind of like the former version of myself fell into, is I think jobs give people a false sense of security. Like, well, I have a job, so I'm safe. And right now when we're recording this, our world is a mess. Like, people are getting furloughed and laid off. And I think a lot of people are now starting to question that thought process. But when a lot of people join the Free Mama community, I think one of their biggest hangups is this secure? Can I actually have reliable income as a freelancer? I think one of the other big holdups is something that other small business owners would face as well, is what about benefits? You know, my job, no, I didn't have a control over my salary or how much I was paid or how many hours a day I had to put in the office, but they contributed to my 401k and I had health insurance and all these other things. So those are some of the biggest objections that I think people have to overcome. And my answer to both of those is really simple, and it's kind of cliche, but it's like, if you want excuses, you're going to find them. And if you want solutions, you're going to find them. I mean, my family has never gone without health insurance, but you have to get creative. You're not getting it from an employer. So you have some choices. Are you going to go through the exchange? Are you going to go through a private broker? Are you going to go through, you know, certain faith-based organizations actually have community pools of being able to get advantage of health insurance. And so there's options, but it's, do you have that willingness to go figure it out? It's not going to be handed to you in a packet from HR. When you decide to be self-employed, that comes with some responsibility of navigating some of these other things. So I think those are some of the biggest objections that I think people have, is this safe? And what about all that other stuff? What about savings? What about retirement? What about health insurance? And as far as, you know, is it secure? There's definitely things that you can do to make it just as secure, if not more secure, than an employer. One of the most amazing benefits as being a freelancer is that you can give yourself a raise anytime you want. In fact, I actually encourage my clients, every new client that you take on, you should be reassessing whether or not your rates need to change. You know, I call it the staircase method. So when you first get started, you might not have as much confidence. You might be new to providing whatever service you're providing, whether you're a virtual assistant or a copywriter or graphic designer, social media manager, but you gotta start somewhere. So start a little bit on the lower end, get experience, build your confidence. And guess what? You don't have to wait a year for an annual review from a boss to maybe get a raise. You can raise your rates with each client that you take on. And so there's so much more opportunity for growth when you take control of your own, of providing your own services.
That totally makes sense. And I know that you're actually not a fan of Upwork. So can you tell me why? And like,
I can't tell you why.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you know what? It's a personal choice. It's not, we're not getting nasty. This isn't something.
No, because I just was wondering, these are like my actual questions. Cause when I was starting my business, I was doing a little bit of freelancing on the side. And I was like, so when you said that, I was like, oh, that's interesting. So why is it? Cause I'm sure there might be, I mean, there's something that people can benefit from.
Yeah. Right? So my personal reasons for not liking platforms, and honestly, even like LinkedIn as a platform for freelancers or Fiverr or any of these other different, you know, there's a lot of them, but Upwork I think is a pretty well-known one. There's a couple reasons. On the freelancer side, I don't care for it because I think kind of by definition, it starts to drive prices down. People start to get competitive. You're also dealing with freelancers from all over the world. And in other markets, you might be able to find a virtual assistant for $3 an hour. And that might be sustainable cost of living for somebody living, you know, in India, for example, but that's not in the United States. And so I feel like the quality of work starts to go down and the prices that you're able to put out there start to go down because of that. It's also incredibly competitive. And you have to look at it this way. And this is, you know, this kind of gets into what I do teach people to do instead of going to these job platform type places, is it's very competitive because these are warm and hot leads being presented to you. If a company is going to go on and post a job opportunity for an independent contractor, they obviously, I mean, it's right there. It's a hot lead. And so you can imagine, it's kind of like when you're sitting outside in the dark in springtime and you flick a light on and all the bugs go to it, right? It's like, it's right there. And so what I prefer to do instead, so you don't get kind of drowned out in all of that, and you're spending a lot of time writing proposals and working on your portfolio on Upwork and doing things that aren't exactly income producing activities, I prefer to build my business through networking, through relationships. It's also a lot more effective way to start growing your book of business, because who do we trust? We trust our friends. We trust the people we know and the people we've worked with. And so I built my business primarily based off of building my own relationships with people. And from there, you then get access to their network. So for example, let's say that you reached out to me and you're like, hey, Lauren, I'm actually looking for a new copywriter right now. Do you know anybody? Well, now, not only do you know all the people that you know in your life, but you now have access to my network because we know, like, and trust each other. So there's a really good chance that if I said, hey, I've worked with this person before, you need to talk to them, you're now probably going to trust them a lot faster than you would if somebody just applied for something on Upwork where you're not getting any of that personal relationship. You don't have one degree of separation. It's really a complete stranger on the internet. So as to Upwork, because I don't want to go in and have a bunch of strangers vying for my work, I'd rather, you know, pick up the phone or jump on Zoom and talk to you and be like, hey, I'm looking for someone to help me with this. Who have you used for, you know, your website or your book publishing or whatever it is that I'm looking for? And so I think focusing on people rather than these kind of quick wins of hot leads online is a lot more productive way to go about building.
I mean, I totally agree, because as a employer, I use Upwork, and oh my gosh, is one of the toughest.
It's exhausting.
I get like a gazillion proposals,
yeah,
and I have to go through them, and I'm like, it takes days for me to find a person, and it's the biggest headache. So I feel like as an employer, I want to know, okay, how do I get to the network? Like, and it's very, very eye-opening. And I do agree with you, because I mean, I've seen good things. Like, I have like people who actually work for me that I found on Upwork, but it took a very, like, 8 years of me just going through people and people and people. Whereas I don't know how else I could have done it. You're right. Now the people that I trust the most work for me, freelance for me, are the ones that, like, have been my students, I've known, yes, in the past. Yeah.
And so I actually have, this happened very organically in my own company, is that I actually have a matchmaker directory now, because I've trained thousands of freelancers. So it just, so many people kept coming to me like, hey, do you have someone for this? Someone for this? I'm like, let's just give all of these women who have gone through my course, let's give them, you know, a platform where they can showcase what they do. And so now I can just send entrepreneurs directly to them, and I stay out of it. I'm not an agency, and I just make connections all day long. So it's a great way to go, to know that someone's been vetted and trained and comes with an endorsement, and to be able to trust them. And it's a little harder to do on a platform the size of Upwork.
Right. I mean, it just reminds me of Tinder for dating. So you're a matchmaker.
It is. Oh, I know. But it is. It's like, hey, what's your style? What's your business?
Yeah, I know.
What's your
style? And I think the thing is, at the end of the day, I mean, whatever works for you. Because, I mean, as much as I hate Upwork, I did meet my husband on Tinder. So I'm like, oh, actually, Tinder do work.
That's awesome.
So whatever your style is. And the reason why I really wanted to have Lauren on today is because times are tough. I know a ton of you guys have, maybe you even loved your job, but now you have no choice but to sit home and not get a paycheck. And I just wanted to bring you all these opportunities so that you can start make money, because this is the best time to start investing. So you have to get that cash flow. And I feel like even if you go back to work, you still can do hustle. And I don't know, I don't like the word hustle, I believe, as well. Either.
I don't like the word hustle. You know so many, like,
I know. I don't know how I know. I think I was on one of your live videos one day.
That is so funny. Said, oh, I'm like, wow, you know, I don't like Upwork. You know, I don't like hustle. Here's the deal with hustle. And let's not confuse hustle for hard work. I work hard. I work smarter than I work harder. So I'm very intentional with how I spend my time. I'm very intentional on the tasks that I do. And I think this is something that can serve everybody watching this, whether you want to get into freelancing or not, is just to adopt that mentality of how can I become more efficient, whether that's through outsourcing, through, you know, kind of getting over yourself. There's a lot of mental stuff that goes into any kind of business is, you know, well, I have a fear of failure, or fear of what other people think about me, or fear of, you know, screwing up, or whatever whatever you've got going on. The more you can kind of master that, the more time you'll save as well. And so I do work hard, but I work very intentionally. And so, yeah, the Gary V, like, working, hustling all day, every day, I don't do that. And I've still found a lot of success. So I know that
you're
possible.
A free mama.
Yeah.
You're a free mama, baby. No, I totally get it. And it is interesting, like, the words that you put it in. And oh, another thing I know about you, I don't know, I have a lot of these, like, random information about you.
I love it.
time control freak.
I am a time freak. I am. You can try, just call it like
that's
it is.
So much. I've been stalking you for years. No, I'm joking. These are super great information. So what is it? So I don't want this video to go super long because I know, first of all, we have crying babies in the background. Jasmine is crying there. But she didn't go to sleep. I don't know what's happening. We started potty training her last. It's been crazy. So, but I do want to give people an option that if they want to take it seriously and not like just make a bunch of random mistakes and go on Upwork and spend a bunch of time creating a portfolio. And instead of like doing all that, just really, how long do you think it will take for somebody who's in need of cash right now, who's lost their job? How long does it take to get their first client?
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of like, I'm sure a question somebody would ask you, I'm like, how long will it take to get a return on my investment? Like,
well, I tell them 10 years, so I hope it's
yeah,
not
well,
10
years. Yeah, well, no, this won't take you 10 years, I promise, this won't take 10 years. But there are a lot of variables, right? Like, what skills are you already bringing to the table would be one of them. You know, what kind of professional background do you have? What does your network look like? Meaning, how many people do you already No. So how many, you know, what skills do you currently bring to the table? How many people do you already have inside of your network? You know, if you've been a stay-at-home mom for 20 years and you haven't, you know, been a part of a workforce, how many people do you know through friends and family? Like that kind of stuff. And it's not like going down the network marketing, like everybody's got skin and everybody's got nails, so you're going to go sell to your friends and family. However, one of the things that will make you more successful as a freelancer is making sure that your community, your network knows what you do. Again, that comes back to referrals. So I have students who have gone through my courses who have found their first client in as little as 2 weeks. And again, the beauty of freelancing is that you're in control of how much you charge, but also when you charge. So depending on the kind of work you do, you can actually get paid in advance. You don't have to do the work first. You can get paid and then do the work. So it's all situational. And my role and my job and what I do in my community is empower you to make those decisions and feel really confident about it while delivering super awesome work. This isn't about shortchanging other people or anything like that. It's about really showing up as the best version of yourself, providing an awesome service, but being compensated really generously for it and becoming known for that thing.
All right, now I want to dig into your membership area and snack some people. I need workers. I need freelance.
Well, we're ready. We got you.
Well, so that's the thing. Like a lot of us online businesses now, I need more and more help. And like even people, like businesses have changed because of coronavirus and they'll continue to change. So I definitely do believe that the need for this is just going higher. So you guys, absolutely, just listen to Lauren. She is Lauren Golden. She's just golden, right? So I'm going to add a link. Yeah, to you have a masterclass webinar that walks you through exact steps they need to take so that you can get started. And she has an amazing community that you definitely need to be a part of. And I think that's how I know so much about you, because I'm in your Facebook group. It's awesome. So I'm going to add a link to that in the description area of here.
I love it.
And you guys go make money and then start investing and then just take this opportunity. I want to look at coronavirus and this whole situation as an opportunity to grow and come out of it much stronger, wealthier, happier, all the good stuff.
Right. Now really is an amazing time because, you know, even our brick and mortar businesses are having to figure out ways to survive this time using virtual means, and they need help because that's not something they're already equipped to do. So there is a lot of opportunity right now. And much like you, I've actually added 2 people to my team since this all started as well. So there's a lot of opportunity, and I'm excited to share this with everybody that you can take control of your financial situation. And then you pop back over to her to invest it and actually grow your wealth. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing.
It's an awesome circle. I love it. I love it. Thank you so much, Lauren. We're gonna add your social handle over here as well. Go follow Lauren. It's gonna be, I don't know, over here. And this is not an investing video. I'm going out with my normal outro. I normally say invest responsibly, freelance responsibly, and I'll see you in the next video. Oh, one tradition. I normally ask my guests to make a silly face.
A silly face? Okay. Like on 3 or for a long time?
Do it.
Oh, just me?
Just you.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh my gosh. Oh my God, you're so... I'll give it a go. Like, nobody has ever negotiated with me. Is it just me? Is it this? Is it that?